quiere à lui.
Ganga photo.
Koffi Olomide is one of Democratic Republic of Congo's most prolific musicians with a string of hits under his belt. The man goes by numerous nicknames including Grand Mopao, Mokonzi, Chacho King, Shakespeare of Zaire, Golo Lupemba and Sarkozy after former French President Nicolas Sarkozy. Koffi made his debut as an excellent songwriter when most of his earlier compositions in the late 70s and 80s were released through Papa Wemba's Och Viva La Musica band. Koffi has distinguished himself as a singer, dancer, producer, and composer. With a catalogue of classic hits such as Chacho,
Chacho, Elamai,
Malene, Malene, Amada, Musema, Emalene, Amana, Mugurugure, Amelia.
And Loa, backed by his Quartet Lata Antonacion Orchestra. Decades after his debut as a highly sought after performing artist, Koffi has stood the test of time and is one of Africa's wealthiest performing artists. Koffi is famed for his eccentric fashion style and continues to rule Africa's airwaves with popular Ndombolo tunes. Koffi turns 60 this year and is married and the father of 7 children. In recent months, Koffi Olomide's latest release, Selfie, has become extremely popular among the selfie generation. I got a chance to take a selfie with the man himself.
Kanga photo.
I'm Koffi Olomide. I'm on Citizen TV with Lilian Molly, the beautiful Lilian Molly.
And after that, this is what he shared with me.
Thank you very much for joining us. This is One on One. My name is Lilian Muli, and tonight we are very proud to be hosting Koffi Olomide. He's in the country after 10 years, and we're so excited to be hosting him tonight. Use the hashtag One on One to talk to us. Koffi Olomide, bienvenue. Thank you for coming.
Merci beaucoup. Vous parlez français. Je suis content.
I don't speak French, but just very little. Okay. Let's begin with the fact that you used to compose songs for Papa Wemba. How did working with Papa Wemba influence your musical journey?
I didn't work with him. It was a pleasure for me to give him something because I appreciated the artist, the singer. This time I was a student in Switzerland, and he knew that I wrote songs, I played guitar, but I was a student, so I didn't know what to do with my songs. So my song was gift for him.
Mwana wa matomo bola tazo bembe tomo indo
Let's talk about your stage name, which is Koffi Olomide.
No, that's my name.
That's your name?
My name, yes.
Because word has it that your real name is actually Antoine.
Yeah. Anthony.
So it's Anthony.
Anthony.
Anthony. Yeah. Christophe.
Yeah.
So why Koffi Olomide? How did Koffi Olomide come about?
The truth is, my mom was not married with my father. When I was born, my father wasn't there. She couldn't give me the name of my father. My father was her boyfriend. And my mom originally is half Yoruba, Nigeria, half Sierra Leone, but born in Congo.
So you have Nigerian roots.
Olomide, it's a Yoruba name. Yes. It means someone coming out from water, from river. But Antoine is the name of my mom was very sick, and a neighbor helped her with me, and this mom gave me, how you say in English,
milk.
Uh-huh. The neighbor, by gratitude, to say thank you to this mom, he gave me the name of the husband of this lady, Anthony.
Good to know. So you are the founder of artists such as Ferragola and Fally Ipupa. How does seeing their success make you feel as the person that discovered them or that trained them or mentored them?
In Kenya, you say Kenya Airways, the proud of Africa.
Yeah.
Fally, Ferre, Sindileke, Soleil, the proud of Koffi of Castellaten band. They are my sons. I'm their father. Perhaps the question is, how our father is still in the competition,
yeah,
till now.
So how have you managed to still remain the biggest star in your genre of music?
I think that I'm sure that the public feels that the guy who's singing is a true artist, that the artist loves what he does, what he sings. That's my secret. I sing because I love to sing, because I love the public. I'm here in Kenya because I missed the Kenyan public too much.
10 years.
10 years. They pay me almost nothing. Almost nothing.
Really?
Really.
The last time you were here?
No, now. I accepted. I asked my staff, my office, to sign, because I wanted Kenya absolutely.
So you sing in French, Lingala, and we don't understand what you're saying for us Kenyans. But what do you think it is that attracts people to your beat, to your sound, to the mood? Why somehow, if you're singing about a love message, even if I can't understand what you're saying, will I know that this is a very emotional song? What is it about your music that speaks to people that don't even understand French or Lingala?
You know what? I was telling you that the public feels the truth. The public feels that in each song there is a part of my heart. I'm like a friend, like a brother, like a parent for the public everywhere in Africa. They know me. They know that with Koffi we can be in confidence.
So you have a degree in business economics and you hold a master's in mathematics, but you preferred to go with music. This is your passion. Why did you not actualize or practice in this field that you have studied it?
I think it's a decision of God. I don't think I'm sure. But I think that if I did economic, I should be another Koffi successing also. I love so much music that I'm not surprised to be today the slave of music. And I like that.
and your latest single, Ekwasi Ke, is a big hit here in Kenya.
You speak Lingala?
I don't know.
Ekwasi Ke, you know the meaning?
I know that it has something to do with a selfie.
You know the meaning.
I don't know, tell me.
No, you will explain us. You.
I don't know, I'm asking
what you think it means.
I think it has something to do with taking a selfie until you get the correct shot. I don't know. Until you get the correct pose.
Okay, it's perfect. that's the answer.
Is that what it means?
Yes.
Okay, we want to hear it from your words.
It's a selfie and everything is not in... What you said?
The pose.
The pose. And what else?
Until you get the right...
Yes.
This is still coming from my mouth.
Yeah.
But of all your songs that you've written, which one is your all-time favorite? Out of every song that you've written, do you have one particular one?
Is it possible to have one song between 400? Is it possible?
Not easy.
I can't say Luther King, Martin Luther, the one I'm writing now, reggae song. About racism, about black people, white people. Mm. You will call me Koffi. I'm Lilian. You were right. Mm. This Martin Luther King song about racism is.
So you want to take a reggae beat with this particular new?
It's done already.
Okay.
It's done. We are seeing what we can change. It's there. Okay.
Okay. Mm. And what brings you to Kenya?
I speak about Jomo Kenyatta, about Mandela, about Bob Marley, about Haile Selassie, about Cassius Clay, all our heroes, black heroes, Mandela, the number one in this song.
Why do you feel that the upcoming Lingala artists, there are many across Africa, why do you think that not many are able to climb to the heights of Koffi? Is there a lack of mentorship? Because there's a lot of bands in Tanzania, there's a lot of bands in Uganda, Congolese bands, very promising artists, but they sing Koffi's song. Why do you think that these very talented young men and women are not rising to reach to your level?
Even me, you know, when I was younger, I used to sing the artists I liked. In France, like Johnny Hallyday, Frank Sinatra, my star, me, my size, Michael Jackson. The one who taught me a lot in my job. In my profession, Michael Jackson. For me, he's the best forever. Mm. I think they see how Koffi do the job, and I think they're right to try to do like him, to sing like him. They're right, I think.
Do you speak a bit of Swahili at all?
Nakupenda.
And what else do you know how to say?
Leo.
Yeah.
Leo in Kenya, Nyama Choma.
Okay, so a bit here.
If you speak, I will
speak. Habari yako Koffi Olomide.
Habari mzuri.
Mzuri sana. Mzuri,
yes.
Karibu Kenya.
Asante sana, Lilian.
Okay.
Yeah.
What brings you to Kenya this time round? Tell us about
I love this country. Everybody knows that. You know, I've been here in show like 50 times in my life, also in Safari Park, in the Carnival, in Mombasa, Eldoret. I love this country, I love these people. I'm very, very happy to be back in Kenya, in Nairobi after 10 years. We are excited, all my band, all my staff.
Your dancers, the choreography, do you do the choreography yourself?
For selfie, everything from myself.
From yourself?
Yes. Everything, all the choreography.
Could you just sing a little bit of a Koffi Ke for us, if you don't mind?
Mama.
Good evening.